Here's what I've been up to in Unity. I've been developing this astronomy package, the goal being to more accurately model the motion of the sun, moon or moons, rings, if the planet has them, and even the star field in the background. My sources for this were several articles on Wikipedia about the position of the sun, the orbit of the moon, and celestial coordinate systems. I've also borrowed the Skydome shader from the Unity forums and adapted it to, you know, suit the package better. My assumptions in this, to simplify some of the math, is to assume that the orbits are circular rather than elliptical, given that the eccentricity of the orbits is extremely small. The other assumption is that the moons are already tidal-locked. That's the feature that causes, you know, the same side of the moon to always be facing the planet. So I don't handle, you know, if a moon were still rotating. Going over my Unity hierarchy here, I've put all the celestial stuff into one object. On that object, I run a script called GameTime. It handles adjusting the angle of the sun, rotating the celestial sphere, keeping track of the time of day and time of year, along with you know, the axial tilt of the planet and the current longitude latitude. I also use this time scale slider to either start advancing time or to really get it spinning. Also in the hierarchy here, so there's a main camera for the celestial area. And then there's a separate camera attached to the first-person controller over on the terrain. So the terrain area is essentially, you know, your normal game play area where the player is running around doing things. And all the celestial stuff happens in essentially in its own little bubble. And the cameras through a script are synchronized in their rotation. So that way, with essentially, you know, simple rendering pass, the sky is drawn from the second camera. In here, I also have several moons, so I'll focus in on. And I've borrowed these from Dragonlance, so that's why there's a red, or white, red, and dark, almost black moon. These objects have their own script, which borrows time from the celestial object. The moons have parameters including the orbital inclination, because they're not always perfectly aligned to the planet's equator. And then, you know, some parameters to handle that inclination of the tilt of the orbit. Actually itself rotates around during a period of time. That's called the nodal period, separate from the orbital period. A lot of the details of what these parameters mean are from the Wikipedia articles, so it's easier to explain by looking at those pages. But here in the hierarchy, I've got the three moons. Each of them has different sets of parameters. I currently have them set at zero inclination, so they're locked on the equator, because it helps with having actual alignments of the moons, which I have one kind of programmed in here to come up. The rings actually is treated just like another moon. Here, though, I've added an object to represent the planet. It's so that if it were in Unity Pro, this should cast a shadow on the rings, so that way you'd be able to see in the game world when a shadow was being cast on the rings as well. The star field here is not just the star field texture map, which here is a front-faced cull shader, but this shader, which as I said was adapted from the Skydome shader, also handles when it's daytime as well. If I advance, you know, time for a bit. It becomes daytime. There we go. We get a blue sky, slightly brighter around where the sun is. This is a lens flare attached to the directional light of the sun. Darker blues away from the horizon. And at nighttime, it does get a little more orange-red. It fades a little too quickly into stars, but it suits enough to show when it's daytime. Oh, and for the sun, there's actually two directional lights here. They're on different culling masks. The one directional light helps to illuminate the gameplay terrain. And so that's where the sun will also change color and more or less fade out at sunset. Whereas this other light for moons, its culling mask is set to just the celestial group to keep the moons illuminated at nighttime. That's the hierarchy. And with everything scripted and tied together, I go in advanced time now. Everything spin around, including in the game view. Really advanced things. Here we have very close to sunset, the night of the eye, alignment of the three moons, and there's a nice sunset red fade to star field. The reason why, of course, this alignment is happening near sunset and not exactly at noon or something is because currently I have the longitude latitude set to where I am on the west coast in California. But if I stop time and change my longitude, if I can get to see now, here it's starting to go out of alignment, but from a different part of the world, it's how the alignment would look. So, that's basically how it works. The other features of this, because it includes the axial tilt of the planet, you do get seasons out of this. If I advance the time at, have it set at scale 6. So this is a solar day per frame. So of course the moons are spinning by, but you're seeing the sun at a different position at the same time of day over the course of years. And it forms this figure 8 called an analemma. So it was interesting that all my calculations brought up this feature, which occurs on Earth, of course, too. Of course, Earth looks a little different because we do have that eccentricity in the orbit and varying orbital speeds, which I've simplified to being a circular orbit and constant speed here. And of course, because the way the light is directional, you get lunar phases with the lunar orbital inclination, which I can demonstrate here. An object I normally have hidden is the orbital plane. Show you, that's the plane that the moon orbits on. but that we can show how inclination. I don't have it paused. Pause it. Time zero. Normally, the Earth's moon is inclined to a little over 5 degrees. So this is where you can see that the orbital plane crosses the plane of the rings, which is on the equator currently. The ascending longitude would adjust this. And so by adjusting that, with these parameters in a game, you could actually affect when you get eclipses or other lunar alignments. This doesn't show eclipses, of course, because I don't have Unity Pro, so I'm not getting shadows. I'm also still having to figure out how to get shadows cast from the moon onto the terrain where I'm at. It might just have to be where I do a calculation between the light and the moon to determine whether or not I should dim out the sun further. There's also no atmospheric distortion at the horizon. It's the thing that normally makes the moons look larger when they're on the horizon. It also affects the sun. And when it's nighttime, since there's just a spherical texture mapping, kind of get this limitation of the resolution of the texture at the poles. So you don't quite get the obvious where the North Star should be. Instead, kind of get this gap. But other than that, looks pretty good for what I set my goals to be. Okay.